I feel bad, and I just got to keep working. And, you know, I owe it to my seniors to keep working hard and not letting up, and I just win the rest of these games.
Largest margin of defeat by the home team this season to a team, one of only two in the country, joining Vanderbilt to start their fourth different quarterback this season. The only team in college football with a pair of freshmen at QB on its depth chart. First quarter was as exciting as a college football game could be. Kent Myers, 6-yard touchdown to Hunter Sharp. USU, under head coach Matt Wells, now 13-1 when they score first.
The Yosemite St. Just, that running back, an excellent play call. Deception at its best. That's a touchdown, second of the season for the Yosemite St. Just.
Only the second time in 2014, UH scored on its opening drives. Then, one of those plays that I told you about.
Second and 5 from the 30. Myers looking to pass down the middle of the field.
Has the receiver wide open. Short. Again. Across the 10. Touchdown. Utah State. 70 yards.
So first and 10, Hawaii. 45-yard line. Woozy looking deep. And Woozy has Dylan Amorico. Has Dylan Amorico. Oh, my.
Rainbow Warriors, oh, they had answers early. Ikaiku Woozy, 1-yard TD toss, Justin Vele's first trip into the end zone of his career.
Justin Vele, man, I love that guy. You know, he's a grinder, he's a hard worker. You know, he doesn't say much, but when it comes, you know, to work, you know, he puts in that work. So, you know, it definitely felt good to get, you know, him a touchdown because he deserves it. You know, he's a real humble guy, and, you know, he works extremely hard. So, you know, I'm glad that Justin Vele did finally get one.
I was waiting for that, for him to score a touchdown all these years, man. And he works hard, man. He knows, you know, from an old teammate of mine in high school, you know, he works hard. And I'm very happy for him. I'm very proud of him. You know, he got a couple carries today, too.
14-14 after the first quarter. UH, 17 plays, 151 yards in that opening quarter. Utah State, 16 plays, 166 yards. Second quarter, another one of those plays.
So you'd like to see their quarterback now take control of this offense. Nikaka Woozy slumped out of the pocket, and Nikaka Woozy goes down and fumbles the football. Vigil with a hit on the quarterback and a touchdown.
28-14 at halftime after Ronald Butler pulled in this 39-yard score. Kent Myers, freshman signal caller that had his red shirt yanked last week, perfect before the break. 11 for 11, 3 touchdowns. Myers, the kid at QB, in fact, completed his first 12 passes and packed with a very simple game plan. He only misfired once all game. After the Rainbow Warriors' two TDs, they didn't score again. From 14-14, UH had 4 punts, 2 interceptions, a fumble return for 6, and 3 series of 3 and out.
We practice so much, so hard, and it sucks to get this outcome. But, I mean, like you said, we got to just keep grinding and playing for pride now.
35-14 final score. Hawaii now 2-7, 1-3 in the MWC. Aggie 6-3, 3-1 in conference. Make it 16 in a row that Utah State has won when they've got a 100-yard rusher. Lawan Hunt, the 5th straight rusher over the century mark against Hawaii's defense. Questions? I'm sure. We'll try and get them answered. I'm Robert Kekaula. This is Norm Chow, Inside Access, here in OC Sports.
I mean, we came off strong, you know, momentum started kicking in. And again, just like every other game, we shot ourselves in the foot. And a good team like this, they capitalized on it. And, you know, it was hard for us to catch up. And, you know, they did their defense quite well. And, you know, they stopped us. You know, all the little things that coach told us, coach keep harping about, you know, we didn't take care of that tonight.
Welcome to Norm Chow, Inside Access here on OC Sports. I'm Robert Kekaula. And welcome to the coach of University of Hawaii football team, Norm Chow. Coaching cliches. Over the tenure of being a coach, I'm sure you've heard the snickers and people laugh that it's just coaching cliches. Pretty simple, though. Turn it over, you lose. You get too many penalties, you put yourself in harm's way. You make mistakes, you lose. All true.
All true, especially against good football teams, Robert. You know, every week we talk about our game plan. It's to play great defense, to not turn the ball over, play good special teams, and to try to win the fourth quarter. And you know, it becomes redundant after a while, just talk after a while, but it's true. And we didn't play great defense. We didn't take care of the football, and hurt us.
Start from the beginning, first quarter. I mentioned the numbers both teams put up offensively. It was, in fact, as good as it could be if you're a fan of college football in that first quarter.
It was. It really was. And, you know, that's the fun part of college football, and that's the fun part of rooting for a team, I think, is that, you know, you want to see a good game, and it was a good game. Both sides offensively did a nice job, but then they dug in defensively, and then, then we made a couple of critical errors.
Now, as it went, your offense started rolling. You had answered early on, you know, Stephen Lakalaka here, at some tough, hard yards after making the reception. And I really did think, for maybe the first time this season, 11 really looked like a quarterback.
He did. He played awfully well. He stayed in that pocket. He executed what the plan was. The turnover was unfortunate early. The second one, when he just, you know, we threw it up for grabs, whatever, try to make something happen. But he did. He's coming along. You know, remember, he's a young guy. He's a young player, experience-wise, and he'll get better as we go along.
Now, he put it on Keelan Evilico on that 54-yarder, and there's that touchdown pass to Justin Velle. I thought the pitch to Diosome St. Just was absolutely great play. Ekeke Woolsey, 26 of 46, 356 yards, the touchdown, and two interceptions.
We're good. You know, we came in, you know, we played assignment football, and everyone was doing their job, you know, doing their 1-11. And as you can see, you know, we put those two scores into the end zone. But, you know, you don't win a game in the first quarter, you know. So we got to carry those things over to the second quarter, third quarter, and fourth quarter. We were making good drives, you know, we're getting down to the red zone. But when it came down to it, you know, when we just couldn't punch it in. And, you know, it's kind of been a story that we had all year. And, you know, it's frustrating. And obviously, you know, me being a quarterback, me being the leader, you know, that's on me. So I just got to do a better job. You know, I just got to change up what I'm doing and just get better. And
a lot of different players got their hands on the football. Quinton Pedroza, 8 catches, 123 yards for him. Had a long reception of 29 yards. And Marcus Kemp, number 14, your tall receiver, 6'4", 6 catches, 56 yards. Total offense, 464 yards for Hawaii. Second best showing of this 2014 season. You got it rolling there for a while.
We did, but, you know, we had to play catch up, and we were throwing it all over the lot, and they started blitzing, and so it made it tough protection-wise. But, you know, you can't fall behind like that, and that's why maybe the yards are a little misleading. But, yeah, we moved the football, and the guys were still fighting right to the very end.
It's a career best for Ekeke Woolsey, the 356 yards. Before we roll this next video, your thoughts on Utah State's offense? They simplified it for a young quarterback.
Well, they did and they did. You know, they did a nice job of running the ball. They ran a lot of cutbacks, what we call cutback runs, and took the heat off of that young guy. But then when he had to make a play, he certainly did.
Now, when that offense gets going, we mentioned the young freshman at quarterback. They started with Joe Smith as the guy carrying the load here at running back. Then they changed to yet another freshman in Lawan Hunt. They got it rolling early. And then that entire first half, they had answers for what Hawaii threw at them defensively.
Well, you know, the throws should not have happened. The long throws, you know, I think we were coverage-wise, Kevin had us in the right coverage. We just made a couple of mistakes. But, you know, you can't do that. You just can't do that.
So they hit the big one, the 70-yarder. And this guy was slinging it like he had game experience, but we had defensive errors, Hawaii did, that just allowed these guys to be that wide open.
Well, we did, but, you know, again, had a nice scheme and made some nice things happen. You see that throwback. I think Kevin practiced that all year, all week long. He knew that was coming, and, you know, unfortunately, they got us.
So the quarterback, his name, Kent Myers, 14 of 50, throwing the football, just one misfire. 186 yards, 3 touchdowns. That's pretty good work. And his receiver, Ronald Butler, 6 catches, 79 yards, and a touchdown. Also threw that reverse throwback pass, a 44-yard touchdown. And the running back, Lawan Hunt, 30 carries for 153 yards. Utah State the good football team. Make no mistake about it. The program, you go back 15 years, what they, how far they've come, it's a quality program.
It is. It is. And I told our players that. It's built on a very, very solid foundation. And you've been up there. You've seen the facilities. They've made a commitment to it. They've built it. Gary Anderson, prior to Matt, did a nice job before he left. So, you know, he left for a better job. But the foundation was there. Matt was very fortunate to take it over and continue the tradition. And, yeah, that, it's a good program. I told our players that. This is a good football team. Will be year after year because of the foundation that's been laid.
We'll talk Hawaii defense. We'll talk special teams when we come back. This is Norm Chow. Inside Access, Prenosi Sports.
I got to do everything I can to help this team get the W, and unfortunately it wasn't enough tonight. I didn't do my 111th enough. We came out with the L, and that's what it shows. I mean, we play this game because we love it. We're going to focus on having fun, and we got to remember why we play this game. And it's unfortunate that we're not able to go to a bowl game this year, not able to contend in all of our endeavors and what we would like to, but I mean, like Coach Chow said, we have to just play for pride, and we can't let that lose sight of that.
You got to love that approach, the mindset. First, accountability. Second, remembering why you play.
You know, we sometimes forget that these are young people and they need to have fun. They deserve to have fun. They've worked awfully hard. I love these kids. I tell them that all the time, that the effort is what I ask, and we get it. Not I, we ask and we get it. And you can't help but enjoy these guys because they are giving you everything they have had. You could see it. They're very passionate about it.
Before we talk Rainbow Warriors on defense, I don't know if you saw these numbers. In my mind, the usual starter at quarterback, Utah State, Chucky Keaton. When healthy, he and Cody Fajardo of Nevada have separated themselves looking like as probably the best quarterbacks in this conference. As a starter, Chucky Keaton is 19-12. That's his record. His backups, it was a freshman in Garrettson last year that started for him. This time around, it's the fourth quarterback of the season in Kent Myers. The backups to Chucky Keaton are 14-4.
Wow.
That, to me, says that's a good program.
Exactly right. Exactly right. Every day you take your time, you mature, you grow, you fill into that role. It takes time. The foundation takes time. And, you know, nowadays, the world we live in, people don't have a lot of time.
Hawaii defense, and I don't want to name names, and I don't want to pick on the kids, but Hawaii's defense, correct me if I'm wrong, they're better than that.
Without question, without question. The last 2 weeks, you know, they're hurt, they're wounded, their pride is chipped up a little bit, but they'll come back. You know, I say it all the time. You know, Moses Samia and Bo Yap and Marcus Malapiai and D Magic, guys that didn't have to buy into us. They were here before we got here, recruited by Mac and his group, and they bought in. They work hard every day. You see them, you know, in practice, and you see the hurt in their eyes as the game goes on when we're not successful. That's who you feel for. Those guys that have tried so hard to make this thing work.
So Tevita Lotai Moore, his second game back from injury, has a tough tackle there, and you see the gang tackling. It's what this defense wants to resemble. It's the Kevin Kloon fingerprint on the Hawaii defense. Kennedy Tuli Masialii, disruptive in the Utah State backfield. And you get stuff like this. Not too many defensive coordinators blitz a corner. And Naquan Phillips got home against Kent Myers. And game after game, one thing you notice is the guy that wears jersey 92. Never.
Without question. And a leader and a gentleman and a class guy. And you know, you feel for the young men like that because, like I said, they haven't had the success that they wanted to have and the reason they're at the University of Hawaii.
We talked to Kevin Kloon leading up to the Utah State game. And it's the 100% correct thing to respond to when people ask him, that's the school you just came from. You got to want to get it after him. He's like, no, it's just another team. It's another game. But come on now. You can't get it out of your system. He wanted to do better against Utah State. No question.
No question, he did. And I talked with him this morning. He's hurting, obviously, his pride and all that. We have to move on. Yeah, but sure, he spent the last 4 or 5 years there, knew all those players, knew all those coaches, and, you know, did a nice job for them, helped lay that foundation. But we need to press on. We need to move on.
And not only him, some of the kids that played defense for UH wanted to do better for him.
Coach Kloon really believed in us. He trusted us, and He gave us all the tools. It was there on the table, and we just didn't use, you know, we didn't execute very well. We didn't do our techniques. You know, it wasn't the defense, the Hawaii defense that I had in mind. And to that, Coach Klum, you know, he really took it hard. And I could see it in his eyes. And to me, I know Coach Klum. As a short amount of time of his being here, I know Coach Klum very well. He loves this game very well, and he cares about us, and he loves us. So we just didn't do our job tonight, and, you know, it's a disappointing loss.
Back to the coaching cliches. Mm-hmm. You're a believer that every game, is the outcome is determined by not much more than a handful of plays.
Well, yes, I do, Robert, and that's why we keep preaching playing 60 minutes. But, you know, when you look back over it, there's, 100, maybe 200 plays in the course of a game. And if you just said one, that's probably not as accurate as maybe half a dozen or 10 or 12 like you're talking about. That's probably true.
Good or bad, it'll help you win. Sometimes it'll be the reason why you lose. One of those plays mm-hmm. was this.
So Ben True back to punt. He's got his heels at the back of the end zone. And he gets it off, and there's going to be a flag against Hawaii. The punter got knocked out, Scott Harding. That's the punter there. Scott Harding. He does. Scott Harding gets into the end zone, but that will get called back.
So let us try and explain what happened here. Third quarter. Scott Harding's punt pins them at the 2-yard line. Defense steps up. They stop Utah State from marching on. And on fourth down, Gaetano DiMonte gets called for roughing the punter. Now, the flip side, on the back end of that play, Scott Harding, so it's a 40-yard punt. Scott Harding, 42-yard touchdown return, called off the board. Now, if you flip the script and do the math, because of the penalty, Utah State goes down to score a touchdown. That's like an 18-point swing all against you.
Yeah, that hurt. That hurt. But we were trying to be aggressive. We were trying to make plays. We were behind, a couple of scores at that point in time. Felt we were very, very much in the game. And there's no one to blame, no one to fault for that. We just were trying to be aggressive, trying to make a play.
That was a great punt return, though.
Oh, it was.
By Scott Harding.
Scotty is so valuable. Isn't he fun to watch?
So it's game-changing plays. And you see it, and sometimes you feel it.
Coach Demo really schemed the punt team. You know, he wanted to get a block this week, and he schemed up our punt return very well. He had the weaknesses. He was searching out and watching film. It's just that they were backed up, so it's not a normal punt. You know, the punter has to come in a little bit close because, you know, he was avoiding the safety, and I don't blame him. I don't blame nothing about it. He gave it his all. He gave it his 100%. But, you know, things like that, we just got to – when things not going to always be perfect, you know what I mean? Like, things will go up and down, things will be wrong, but you just got to, you know, dust it off and get ready for the next play and get ready on deep.
Final statistics, Hawaii hosting Utah State look like this. Rushing yards, 235 for the Aggies, 230 in the passing game. You see the third down conversions, 5 for 13 Utah State, 7 for 17 Hawaii. Thing is, Rainbow Warriors started the game on third down situations, 5 for 5. That's a great start. Turnovers, Hawaii 3-0, losing that battle. This is Norm Chow, Inside Access, here in OC Sports. Be back after this timeout.
Just went out. That's our mindset. It's just whenever you feel like giving up, whenever you feel like it's being too hard for you, you know, you just got to think about those seniors, you know. Sad to say, you know, some of these seniors might be the last time they ever shot some football pads, you know, helmets, you know, and they've been playing this game all their lives. And to me, to even think about that, knowing that if I had four weeks left of my career, it's definitely sad.
There's one point if you doubt yourself, you know, if you don't believe that's kind of hard, you know, like one little doubt of non-belief is hard, you know what I mean? It's players giving up and stuff like that, and things won't go our way, but. You know, that's life, you know. Football is a great class of a teacher of life, and we just got to keep believing in ourselves and keep, you know, we know we're a good team. We just got to believe it. That's all we got to do.
Honestly, I've had the same confidence all season. You know, I never doubt myself, never lose confidence in myself, because once you start doing that, you know, bad things start happening.
Welcome back to Norm Chow, Inside Access here on OC Sports. We talked about the handful of plays. It'll be for you or against you, either way. There's a handful of plays that determine the outcome. Turnovers will always kill you. Oh, he loses that battle 3-0.
Yeah. Well, it was two, actually. You know, the last one was the Hail Mary one. But it, unfortunately, that counts as well.
And look at the numbers. Utah State has 25 takeaways this season. That's second best in all of college football.
Wow. Interesting. I didn't know that one.
The other thing that will break you, penalties. Combined, Hawaii and Utah State, 25 penalties for 196 yards in that game. 13 penalties for 100 yards against Hawaii. You were not happy, I bet, watching the penalty flags fly.
No, you know, and we had seven false starts. And I talked to the officials before the game. They do something that's a little bit questionable. But, again, no whining, no complaining. But seven false starts is not like us, so you know something's up.
It's not normally. You're not a penalty-heavy program or football team on offense or defense. It was just one of those nights.
I don't know. Like I say, some of the things that were going on, I talked to the officials about it before the football game, and, you know, whatever. It just happened. But to have seven false starts, normally in a game you have one or two, you can live with that. But seven tells you something's different.
There was one play in particular, your center, Cody Alfasia. He snapped the ball, almost never left the ground. Like, I thought he just dribbled it. I was like, that's not Cody.
Well, again, he was concerned about the fronts and all the different blitzes they were bringing and that what was going on with it. And it was very determined to try to make that right. I think he had two or three, which is not like Cody.
Sometimes along the way, people ask, you hear the term these days, it's the passion for the game. It's the love of the game. Sometimes people want to know what passion, what competition looks like. I think this might be it. This is on the sideline. After you get the roughing the kicker penalty, it's two competitive coaches who want to win. Chris Demarest, your special teams coach. That happens every week. It's football, isn't it?
Oh, it is. It is. I've known Chris forever. You ever disagree with your wife?
This Come morning. But it happens all the time. You get caught up in the heat of the game. It was a big game-changing play. There's no problem there with you and Chris Demarest to clear the record, right?
Gosh, no. I've known Chris since the year 2000. For one of the first guys I called. You always just have disagreements. But, again, passion, wanting to win, competitiveness, that's Chris Demarest.
6'2", 240 pounds. He's a senior. Plays linebacker for Utah State. Zach Vigil. Zach Vigil's a beast at linebacker, isn't he?
He and his brother both.
Now, there was one stretch where Zach Vigil was just making play after play. And he ended up with a handful of tackles. He was in the Hawaii backfield, even forces a fumble. He makes a play on first down, leaves the field, tosses his lunch on the sideline, and then the very next play, Zach Vigil gets off the knee, gets back into the game, and then reintroduces himself to Hawaii quarterback Ikeka Uzi. That's a grown man.
How about that for passion and energy?
That's a cool. Grown man, Zach Vigil. 12 tackles, 11 of them solo. He had 3 tackles for a loss of yards, and he had 3 sacks and a forced fumble. As we go to break, let us show you our choice this week for our Super Cuts that rock from the Hawaii versus Utah State football game. It looks like this. I thought it was a great play call, great execution. It's the flip from Ikeka Woolsey to Diosome St. Just. What may be better than the play itself was the guy that wears jersey 55, Cody Afusia. It's the Big Bear Dance. And Cody Afusia giving it to us as we go to break. This is Norm Chow, Inside Access on OC Sports. Welcome back to Norm Chow Inside Access. We're joined now by Stephen Stye from the Star Advertiser.
It's a lot of S's there. You said Stephen Shy, didn't you?
And what's Warrior thingamajig?
HawaiiWarriorWorld.com. Bunch of links there, you'll find it.
Every day?
Every day.
Blogging?
Every night, too.
Like a madman.
All the time. It's like 7-Eleven. Never closes.
Hawaii, Utah State. 35-14 final for the Aggies. First quarter was awesome, wasn't it, though?
It was entertaining. I like when teams score and do things.
The one thing I get out of it at the end of the game, Utah State's defense. You ask a guy to bring it, oh, they brought it.
Oh, they did. There was just a lot of I don't even know what color jersey that was, but there's a lot of that, whatever, it was like washed out gray just coming at him. It was interesting. They put a lot of pressure on.
Talk to coach about coaching cliches. Turnovers will kill you. Penalties can break you. And every game, there's only a handful of plays that determine the outcome. Are you a believer in that?
Yeah, I believe, yeah, that there are. I mean, obviously, things set up plays, and sometimes you have little plays that set up bigger plays, but there were some big plays, and I think a lot of the long touchdown passes were set up by smaller things like little running games, screen passes, but the big one was that turnover. That was a tough one.
A fumble return for a touchdown, and maybe you can do the math. Scott Harding gets in for a 42-yard punt return. It's called off the board for roughing the punter penalty. So they take the points off, and then they march down. Utah State scores. What's the turnaround on that? 18 points?
I would have to take off my shoes yet, but I haven't gotten that petty yet.
It'd be 18 points, wouldn't it?
I think it is.
Towards the end of the game, well, let me check that. First play of the game, offense, mm-hmm. for Hawaii. He dropped the ball, but the look of Tui Unga, that size young man, in wide open field, I can see a future for that kid playing this game.
Right. And in fact, we've actually seen that before because that's Itula Mealy. That's the same guy. That's the same player. Same play almost.
Yeah, Itula Arakahuku played at BYU under Norm Chow and then in the NFL. Size matters this week. What's the assignment that you chose to accept?
Well, as a father of a poor college student, doing a story on
yes.
poor college students.
So the day in the life, financially speaking, of a student athlete, in this particular case, Rainbow Warrior football player.
How do you get by?
How do I get by? Well, first thing, my parents helped me out a lot, so I'm very thankful for them. Also, my grandparents who just live out in Hawaii Kai, they helped me out a lot too.
I'm blessed to be born and raised here, and fortunately, I have a lot of family on this island, so that's where most of my support comes from.
I'm just happy I'm here and I got the family support, even though if I don't have money or not. And, you know, you stick around with all your friends, borrow, and they owe you back. It's just, that's how it is.
You know, I carefully plan, you know, what to spend, what not to buy, you know, just pay rent and then, you know, save up.
My girlfriend and I were looking for an apartment, and like most of the apartments that we really like was like 3,000 and something. And we just took the 1,300 because we can afford it.
You stretch things out. One, you put at least five people in a one-bedroom house as possible. So it's me, Naquan, Damian Packer, Morrell Jackson, Barry Higdon.
A lot of tuna sandwiches, tuna and rice.
Getting a home-cooked meal on a Sunday after the games is always good too. So
you go to your grandparents after?
Yeah, usually after the games, I'll meet up with them at their house and kind of hang out with them for a little bit.
He's a good cook. He's a chef at the house.
I understand he can stretch a meal.
Yes, he can.
Stretch a dollar. Oh,
yes, he's capable of that, especially with his tuna.
What is great about his tuna?
Just the ingredients that he mixes in it, and it goes perfect with some bread.
What about for laundry and stuff? You go home or you do it over here?
Laundry, I go home, or I do it at my apartment. You know, it's a typical college thing. My family wants me to actually be on my own, be independent.
I live at home, so fortunately I have all sisters and my mother. I try to do it on my own time, you know, try to help them out, but it's mostly my mom.
Morel's in charge of like the cleaning and like the, I guess, the parenting of the house. And what am I?
I run by and run it.
I'm just there, I guess, really just living off of them. I'm the one guy who just doesn't do much. Naquan, I guess he's the father figure because he likes to boss people around. And, Barry. Barry's the one that makes sure that we all need to go to class and we all have our backpacks and lunches before school.
Kids are at home, and I know you're still a big football star. Do they make you do chores or things like that?
Oh, yeah. My dad is the big enforcer on that one. Tells me all the time, I don't care if you go to school and you're hardly home, you still got a 3 or 1-11 at home, you know what I mean?
You know, in that segment, they actually talked about other things, but it's kind of like a rap record sold at Walmart. They had to bleep out a lot of things. So they did not talk about Tuna Helper. They did not talk about Hot Cheetos. They did not.
Now, you're a dad of a college student. The son and the older children bring home laundry for mom?
Yeah, I bring home laundry for the wife, too. Yeah, I don't do very well. I do have, we do, it's better when other people do our laundry because, or else you have a lot of red shirts and white things mixing together. And
Hawaii, on the road this week to play Colorado State. We'll talk about one thing before I let you go. This is the week that running back, the franchise, running back Joey Iosefa is now available to participate.
Right, he's he first was injured and then he had a three-game suspension. The three games are up and he's back to go and he will be practicing this week.
He's a game changer, he's a difference maker. Nothing against Stephen Lakalaka, nothing against Diosime St. Just. I really do believe those two have carried the load very respectably since Joey's been out. But Joey's Joey.
Yeah, and he's just a little bit more experienced. He's just a little tougher runner. And, you know, it's you're right. It'll be nice to see them actually have a full complement of running backs there. And they can do a little more things than they were just kind of limited before.
Can't help to think about a year ago, Joey Iosefa comes off injury, goes 37 carries, 35 carries, and just carried the load offensively. Hope he's healthy. Hope he's ready to go. Stephen Sy, I want to thank you for joining us. This is Dom Chow, Inside Access here in OC Sports. Welcome back to Norm Chow Inside Access here on OC Sports. Here's the standings in the West Division of the Mountain West Conference. On top at 3-2 is a tie between Nevada and San Diego State. San Jose State follows, then Fresno State, Hawaii at 1-3, UNLV at 1-4 in conference. In the Mountain Division, Colorado State 4-1. Remember the name of that school. Boise State 3-1. Then Utah State's right behind. Air Force at 2-2. Wyoming, what a win for them. 2-3 over the weekend at Fresno State. And New Mexico 1-3. And I mentioned remember Colorado State because that's where you go this week. Colorado State, from what we could see last season, big offensive line. We're going to run straight. If you can't stop it, it's going to be a long night for you.
And they have a transfer running back from Alabama that Jim brought with him when he left Alabama. And this it's another formidable challenge, one that I'm sure our guys are looking forward to. You know, we're going to have to hit the road, and we're going to have to play, do the best we can. We're going to have to play the best ball game we played to stay in with these guys.
So it's back-to-back road swings. Colorado State this week, San Jose State next week. What's the travel plans this week? You leave Wednesday or Thursday?
Well, we'll leave Thursday and we'll come home. We'll come home. We can't afford to miss the week of school because the next game is just one shot right into San Jose. So we'll be home, go to school, and then leave again the following Thursday.
You know, we hear from the players, and we heard from some tonight about confidence level, about believing in the product, about trusting yourself. Throughout the struggle of last season and this season, do you ever waver in what your beliefs are about this game of football?
Not me, Robert. I've been in it a long time. You have to have some kind of belief system to last this long, and that's what I love about our players. I absolutely respect and admire them and love them because they feel the same way. You know, you see a little bit shakiness. We talk about it. You saw Lance. You heard Lance. I think all that's very accurate. Not me. I mean, we'll keep fighting. We'll keep trying. We were at work this morning. The coaches are all in there looking at the tapes, trying to get ready for Colorado State.
For the record, turnovers kill you, right?
Kill you.
Penalties absolutely can break
kill
you.
And penalties and turnovers and the mistakes, the costly mistakes just get you.
Coach, safe travels this week on your way to play Colorado State.
Thank you. Thank you for having me, Robert.
And for our entire crew here at OC Sports, I'm Robert Kekalo. For Coach, thank you for watching. Norm Chow, Inside Access here at OC Sports.
Norm Chow Inside Access has been sponsored by Bank of Hawaii, Chevron, and Hawaii Honda Dealers. Norm Chow Inside Access is sponsored by Bank of Hawaii, Chevron, and Hawaii Honda Dealers.
A lot of times it's brushed aside with people saying, it's just coach talk. In this case, Hawaii hosting Utah State at Aloha Stadium. Well, it's true. All true. Most times the outcome of a game is decided by just a handful of plays. Turnovers, they kill you. Penalties can can break you. Rainbow Warriors and Aggies, all true. And UH, on the short side of all those coaching cliches.
It's extremely frustrating, you know. It's anytime you lose, it's something hard to deal with.
He was disappointed in the results. Defense wasn't responding. Offense put up. I think our offense did a great job putting up 14 points, but it's very disappointing on doing our job that we didn't execute very well. We didn't wrap up. We didn't do good techniques. We wasn't doing our 1-11.
We're all frustrated. You know, it is what it is. And coach told us we shouldn't have no excuses about this game. You know, we lost, and it's bottom line.
What kills me most is that I felt like I let the seniors down tonight. You know, because we were still bowl eligible coming to this game. You know, we had the win out, but right now, you know, it looks pretty doubtful for us making the game unless we make like a Mountain West and championship and win that game. So it's hard to deal with. You know, I feel bad, and I just got to keep working. And I owe it to my seniors to keep working hard and not let it up, and I just win the rest of these games.
Largest margin of defeat by the home team this season to a team. One of only two in the country joining Vanderbilt to start their fourth different quarterback this season. The only team in college football with a pair of freshmen at QB on its depth chart. First quarter was as exciting as a college football game could be. Kent Myers, 6-yard touchdown to Hunter Sharp. USU under head coach Matt Wells, now 13-1 when they score first.
The awesome St. Just. Play call. Deception at its best. That's a touchdown, second of the season.